Hey guys, welcome back to FOMO's Zar, where we research everything crypto. Before I begin today's episode, I'd like to make a short disclaimer. I'm obviously not a financial advisor. That being said, take everything I say with a grain of salt and always do your own research. Bitcoin's been really strong for the past couple of days, and I just wanted to make this video just to kind of shed some light on Moonriver. And ironically enough, you know, there were some people, they were spreading FUD, and they were claiming that Moonriver is a scam, or it's just a useless project, right? Like it's a meme, right? I thought that was funny, right? But obviously, we at the channel, we have been DCAing in Moonriver heavy since God knows when. The rewards are getting better, obviously, right, over time, you know, but still a lot of recovery to be made by Moonriver. But I think the market's finally picking up, and if you're not in Moonriver already, you should do some research. You should consider. You should check out what Moonriver is all about, what is going on in the ecosystem, and just exactly how much money and how much value can be generated, right? Because that's what investors do, right? So like, find good projects and do research, and don't FUD yourself out just because you're holding something else. Everything is going to make it. Everything is going to make it. Right? And the more interoperable you get, the better it is. Right? Everyone knows that. Everyone knows that much. Right? Interesting enough, Moonriver also bought its own parachain slot. So, I think I posted it on my Twitter. You guys should follow it if you don't. FOMO's R. You already know. But posted it a while back, to be honest. When it actually got announced. Let me see. Yeah, I don't know. I think it's actually up there, but right there. So, with a self-funded slot acquisition, Moonbeam Foundation is able to direct existing Moonriver reserves to be used for initiatives that help increase the activity and adoption on Moonriver, including grants and developers support. Right. So there's a handful of projects that are even building. On Moonriver, right? So if you just go on DeFi Llama or whatever, you know, whatever you choose to, you know, curate yourself with the whatever projects are going on whatever chain, right? So we can see that the most prominent projects would be like Moonwell. It's holding a lot of total value locked, right? But Moonwell is still relatively new. It's a money market. It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. I definitely would say definitely check out Moonwell. But for people that, you know, want farms and DeFi and all that, right? Because they are all, so basically like everyone's gonna be getting rewards, extra like boosted rewards that were basically supposed to go to like the community. They're still gonna go to the community, but instead of them going for the Kusama that was locked for the parachain for Moonriver to win another slot, now Moonriver just bought its own slot, and all that extra Moonriver that was supposed to be given for the parachain now is just going to be given as like rewards for the community. So basically like how Matic used to receive like extra rewards, or like how Avalanche had like the whole you know, rush, right? Moonriver is about to see the same. And that little tweet was basically like a prelude of that, right? And market was really, really bad, and it still is, to be honest, right? And it's recovering, but you know, there's still fear. There's a lot of doubt. But besides sushi, you could go on sushi and you could take your money there. Besides that, on this channel, we've been covering solar beam heavily, right? Well, not really heavily, I guess. I take it back. But yeah, solar beam. I would say I've covered it a bunch of times. I would say I've covered it a bunch of times. But Rome, I've never covered it. Even though Rome is building a metaverse project, I was just really weary of it just because it is an own fork and it kind of did suffer the same fate. So, but I mean, like, you can't even say that. So, it's like whatever. Finn, also, Huckleberry, we've been covering on this channel a lot. Super, super undervalued, right? It's a money market just like Moonwell. And it's a little bit different, but yeah, they have their own thing. So like for example, Tom, it has like something like Scream. You know, if you're familiar with the staking with Scream for X Scream. So Tom is basically the X Scream version of Finn. So basically your Finn just automatically increases relative to the Tom. Right, so you have more fin because you're holding tall just by holding it. It's called passive sailing. That's what they call it. Anyways, yeah, I would say check out Moonriver. You know, do not write it off as a scam because it's not. It is not. I don't know why. I don't know why people would. I maybe they think like because of the name or something, right? Or maybe I guess the chart's pretty bad too. But like do some research, right? Like everyone does that research in like random pump and dump projects, right? Do some research. You might find a low-key gem hiding. Like this is on daily, right? You guys wanna see how it looks like on hourly? Look at this. Straight wicks. Straight wicks. I like yeah. We're all really wrecked, whoever's in Moonriver. So if anyone's holding, right? So yeah, just hodl. And I would say make sure you actually use your Moonriver to its full potential and maximize your gains. And take like very, very low risk. Very low risk. Because there's no reason for you to take any risk if you're holding Moonriver as is, right? Besides that. But I probably ended off there. If you guys have any questions, if you guys want me to dive into some Moonriver projects in more depth, perhaps I could. You know, I do love Moonriver, right? But yeah, man. So check it out. Check it out. You know, obviously, you know, I don't know. I don't know how. Yeah, I don't know. Anyways, Bitcoin's bullish. Things are looking good, but we're kind of like, you know, we're like literally at the decision, man. And we have to hold it too. It's not just that we have to break it, we have to hold it too. But yeah, that's probably all for now. I'll see you guys in the next episode. So stay tuned in. I'll make more just because, you know, I've been away for so long. I love you guys.